Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ahyar Rosidi, aku kawin kamu Kancil Seniah, Wali Semeton. Semeton wah berwakil lili aku serta mas kawin kepeng logam ₹10,000. Seniah ini menyediakan 3 di rumahnya ya. Misa pertama, penyadang sah pertama ialah sapu tangan ya. Kenapa? Karena kalau pulang suami terus telah selapu keleleh ya. Ya. Ketiaknya dilau semuanya ya. Wah hebat luar biasa. Yang kedua adalah pecut. Kenapa disediakan cemeti? Setelah memasak sayur, masak daun, kalau memang enak sayur saya, itu adalah ibadah bagi saya. Tapi kalau tidak enak, diserahkan. Suruh pecut Ili Yahya deh. Ya bagus ya. Dan yang ketiga adalah kipas atau ampet ya. Kenapa dia sediakan ampet? Karena kalau pulang suaminya dari sawah, karena dia berkeringat, akhirnya istrinya Mutiah ini adalah langsung dia kipas-kipaskan apa suaminya.
To get married and to have a husband remains the ultimate dreams of most women in rural areas of Indonesia. The deep-rooted belief that having a husband means having a protector, leader, and breadwinner to sustain their life and that of their children overwhelms these women's desire to pursue other paths and dreams. On the other hand, for men, a marriage is the manifestation of their capabilities to lead at home and among their people. The affirmation of differences in status, role, and responsibilities between the husband and the wife in Indonesian marriage are often declared officially and openly in wedding ceremonies by Muslim headmen. The husband is the head and leader of the household, and is entitled to full and unconditional service by the wife, who is assumed to be protected, led, and provided for by him. However, in reality, what often happens in society is that women must lead, protect, and struggle to provide for themselves and their families while being treated unfairly and unjustly in their marriage. Siti Nurhalimah is a woman born and raised in the Islamic tradition in Lombok, West Nusa Tenggara in Indonesia. Siti married for the first time when she was 19 years old through a process of merarik, a tradition of her ethnic group. In this tradition, the man rushes in and takes the woman away to his family home. The woman's family must consent to their marriage or else be sanctioned socially by the community.
Apa kata orang dilarikan ke sana kemari terus apa
what
kata orang
what would people say about being rushed in on and taken away here and there by a man if we were not married it would have caused trouble that's why my father gave in and he gave me up to get married katanya bapak. Marriage is the handing over of a woman by her parents to the groom with a dowry and pisuke, a form of compensation given by the man's side. The woman thus becomes the property of her husband.
Di dalam perkawinan saya,
in my marriage, I also help him earn a living. I went to the market every day to sell, but I was not allowed to wear any makeup. I was not allowed to comb my hair, let alone wear face powder, because he was jealous. Siti was divorced for her first husband by religious headman who had wed them, when the husband left to work in Malaysia. Their son, who had yet not turned 1 year old, was taken by her husband's family. Siti has been living apart from her son ever since.
Setelah saya cerai, Andre itu anak saya.
After I got divorced, Andre, my first son, went with his father. because he was not allowed to come with me. I returned to my parents' house with nothing but the clothes that I had been wearing that day. After 2 years of divorce, Siti got married for a second time. The marriage lasted for only 3 years. The couple did not have any children. Her second husband decided to go to work in Malaysia and has never returned, leaving Siti the burden of the debts he incurred to pay for his departure.
Utang-utang itu kan belum saya ganti juga kan, minta sama kakak.
I had to pay for his debts too. I still owe my brother 250,000 rupiah, but I can't pay it because my ex-husband never sent me any money. He didn't got in touch with me for 2 years, never sent me any letter, let alone money. That's why I filed for divorce with the court. 3 years after being divorced from her second husband, Siti was forced to become the second wife in a polygamous marriage of a middle-aged man who kidnapped her according to marriage custom. The third husband abandoned her when she was in late stages of pregnancy while she and her parents were on an umrah, short pilgrimage trip in Saudi Arabia.
Pas saya hamil 9 bulan,
when I was 9 months pregnant, I gave birth in the toilet without help from a doctor or medicines. Only my mother and father were there.